Good morning. So today's class, we are the this is the second session of module 5. Second session of module 5. So it is numerical methods. So last session we studied the forward difference and backward difference, how to form the table.
Yeah.
Now today we directly see the Newton's forward interpolation formula. And similarly, there is also Newton's backward interpolation formula. So today we will discuss Newton's forward interpolation formula and the problems in Newton's forward interpolation formula. So you can see here this what is written here, Newton's forward interpolation formula, which you have to by heart, y is equal to y naught plus p into delta y naught plus p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial delta squared y naught plus p into p minus 1 p minus 2 divided by 3 factorial delta cube y naught. See, you can see the flow. See, first it is p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial delta squared y naught. Next it is p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 by 3 factorial into delta cube y naught plus goes on till p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 till p minus n plus 1 divided by n factorial into delta power n y naught. So here p equals x minus x naught by h. Okay. Here p equals x minus x naught by h. Okay. P equals x minus x naught by h, and h is called the step length. H is called the step length. P equals x minus x naught by h. And h is called the step length. Once again, the Newton's forward interpolation formula is given by y equals y naught plus p into delta y naught, okay, plus p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial delta squared y naught plus p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 divided by 3 factorial delta cube y naught. See, so naturally you can write the next term. Next term will be p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 into p minus 3 divided by 4 factorial into delta power 4 y naught. That triangle shape means forward difference. This forward interpolation formula. And naturally the nth term you can write now. Second means one less. See, 2 means here in this term, 2 means here 1 like that. So here also 2. So I can write the nth term as p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 till p minus of n minus 1, so when you multiply it will be p minus n plus 1 divided by n factorial into delta power n of y naught, divided by n factorial into delta power n of y naught. Okay, h is called the step length. Step length means what is the common difference there. For example, 0, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. So you can see that the step length h is 5. So p is equal to x minus x naught by h here. P is equal to x minus x naught by h. X minus x naught by h, and h is called the step length. So this is known as Newton's forward interpolation formula. This is called as Newton's forward interpolation formula. Okay, we'll see this. Remember this, p is x minus x naught by h. I will tell you later what is x naught. X naught starting value. For x naught, f of x naught is y naught. So f of x naught equals y naught, f of x1 equals y1, f of x2 equals y2, like that. Here h is called the step length. Okay, this is known as Newton's forward interpolation formula. So this is called as Newton's forward interpolation formula. This you have to by heart, because surely one question in model question paper there are problems, you can solve it. Okay, same type I have solved here. Now with so much of idea, this is not known as Newton's forward interpolation formula. With so much of idea, we go to a simple problem now. See, the problem is, problem can be given in many ways. The problem given here is given f of 0 equals 1, f of 1 is 3, f of 2 is 7, f of 3 is 13. Find f of 0.1 using Newton's forward interpolation formula. Again, I repeat, given f of 0 equals 1, f of 1 equals 3, f of 2 equals 7, f of 3 equals 13, find f of 0.1 using Newton's forward interpolation formula. Now, clearly here you can see, xy, okay, x y means you can write the x, you have to form the table. Sometimes they'll give in the table form, sometimes they'll give in this form, function form. So if they give in function form, see the x value is here 0 1 2 3 0 1 2 3 x value 0, that is independent variable 0 1 2 and 3. So x value I wrote 0 1 2 3, and y value, for x value 0 y value is 1 wrote here. For x value 1, y value is 3. For x value 1, y value is 3. For x value 2, y value is 7. For x value 2, y value is 7. For x value 3, y value is 13. For x value 3, y value is 13. Again, repeat. I repeat again. For x value 0, y value is 1. For x value 1, y value is 3. For x value 2, y value is 7. For x value 3, y value is 13. Okay, you got this table. I hope you understood. Sometimes the table will be given directly. Now the step length h, what is it? See, 0 to 1. After 1 comes 2. After 2 comes 3. So you can see there is a common difference. There is a common length which is increasing. That is called the step length. And here clearly the step length h is equal to 1. The step length h is equal to 1. After you know so much of data, you can now form the difference table. This is called forward difference, because Newton's forward interpolation formula. So we go here to do the difference table, that is forward difference table. So what we do, first we write the x column, vertically x column. X is 0, 1, 2, 3, so I wrote 0, 1, 2, 3. Y is 1, 3, 7, 13, correspondingly. X value 0, y value is 1, given in the question. X value 1, y value is 3. X value is 2, y value is 7. X value is 3, y value is 13. So much you know. Then we go on finding out first difference, second difference, third difference, etc. So how to find the first difference? So the question comes, how to find the first difference? So first difference means, here first difference means what we do, see. We take this, see, 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 minus 1 is 2. Okay? 7 minus 3 is 4. 7 minus 3 is 4. 13 minus 7 is 6. That way. So not 1 minus 3. That's wrong. 3 minus 1, 2. We write it in the middle of 1 and 3. See wherever it is. Middle of 1 and 3. First difference. Just like yesterday in the last session we have studied how to find the forward difference, how to form the forward difference table. 7 minus 3, 4 we write here. 13 minus 7, 6 we write here. Then we go to second difference. So when we come to second difference, 4 minus 2 is 2, 6 minus 4 is 2. And similarly, when we come to third difference, 2 minus 2 is 0. Okay, like this we get. Now clearly, x naught is 0, y naught is 1. Clearly, x naught is 0, y naught is 1. And del y naught, all the first leading elements we write down. This is called first difference, that is del y naught, that is 2. This is the second difference, that is del squared y naught, that is also 2. And the third difference, that is del cubed y naught. Third difference, del cubed y naught. That is, you can see here, it is very clearly, you can see here, it is 0. So once again, I repeat, x naught is 0, y naught is 1. And we are writing all the leading elements of each column. Leading elements of each column. So here, del y naught, this is called del y naught, that is 2. Second difference, that is written as del squared y naught, that is 2. Third column is del cubed y naught, that is taken as 0. Now using Newton's forward interpolation formula, the forward interpolation formula means, here you have studied only Newton's forward interpolation formula. We will write, the formula is a big formula, you can see, till nth term. We write only till the third difference is 0, delta cube y naught is 0. Delta cube y naught is 0. We write the Newton's forward interpolation formula only till del squared of y naught. We write the Newton's forward interpolation formula only till del squared of y naught. So y equals y naught plus p delta y naught plus p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial del squared of y naught. And the next term, suppose it is existing, you can write it, it should be p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 divided by 3 factorial into del cube of y naught. Okay, del cube of y naught. Now here, What you can see here is, see, again I repeat, using the forward interpolation formula, you know here only it exists till del squared of y naught, del cube of y naught is 0. So we write the Newton's forward interpolation formula only till del squared of y naught. This is infinite terms are there. We write it only till del squared of y naught because del cube y naught is 0 and what follows next will be 0. So we write it as y equals y naught plus p delta y naught plus p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial del squared y naught. Then next term would be what? You can guess it, what it is. P into p minus 1 into p minus 2 divided by 3 factorial into del cube y naught. Okay. Now this will be equal to, you can see here, y naught. Y naught is 1 plus p. P value. See, we have not found out that. Okay. P value. How to find p value? We don't know now. Time being, we'll keep it as it is. P. Delta y naught. Delta y naught is 2. So 2p. Plus p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial. 2 factorial is 2. 2 into 1, that is 2. Del squared y naught. Del squared y naught is also 2. I wrote 2. So everything cancels. So after it cancels, if you multiply all each of the terms, there are 3 terms. If you multiply each of the 3 terms, after it cancels, if you multiply each of the 3 terms, what do we get? Simple multiplication, you will get 1 plus p squared. So this simplification here, 2, 2 cancels, so p squared. P squared minus p plus 2p, so it is plus p plus 1. So very simple, you get p squared plus p plus 1. This is the forward interpolation formula. The answer what you get here is called as the forward interpolation polynomial. This is called as the forward interpolation polynomial. Okay. Now we will find out what is the value of p. So for the p, to find the value of p, the formula is x minus x naught by h. To find the value of p, the formula is x minus x naught by h. To find the value of p, the formula is x minus x naught by h. What is x? X is the value what you have to find out. See here, find f of 0.1. The value what you have to find, that is the value of x. So f of, find f of 0.1. So x will be 0.1. Minus x naught is the starting value here, that is x naught is 0. So x minus x naught, and see here, x minus x naught, so 0.1 given in the question, find value, what you have to find, that is x. So 0.1 minus x naught is the starting value in the first column, that is 0, divided by h is the common difference, that's 0, 1, 2, like that. So h is 1. So we get 0.1 minus 0 by 1, that is 0.1. So now we put all this, p is 0.1, so y is the function, y is equal to f of x. You can also write in place of y, f of x. So y is equal to 1 plus p squared. So we write y equals 1 plus 0.1 plus 0.1 squared. 1 plus 0.1 plus 0.1 squared. This you know, very simple. 0.1 squared will be, if you multiply, you can also use calculator or you can calculate yourself. 0.1 squared will be 0.01. So 1 plus 0.1 plus 0.01, it will be equal to 1.11. So f of y is equal to f of x, and here x is 0.1. So f of 0.1 is equal to 1.11. f of 0.1 is equal to 1.11. Now we go to the second question. Okay, I hope you understood the first. Please solve it, write the notes. I'm telling again and again, mathematics you have to write and study. You cannot read mathematics. You know that. The following table gives a set of, so the following table gives a set of values of x and the corresponding values of f of x. The following table, second question, the following table gives us, here they are given in the form of table. Just see how the questions can be asked in different ways. The following table gives the set of values of x and the corresponding values of f of x. That means the corresponding values of y. So x value is given 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. Y equals f of x. That is also given. 2.68, 3.04, 3.38, 3.68. So find f of 0.15. Question is, this is x value actually, 0.15. Find f of 0.15. And 0.15 is in the beginning of the table. See, 0.1, 0.2, it is in the beginning of the table. So we have to use forward interpolation formula. If the value is at the end of the table, then mostly you have to use backward interpolation formula. So 0.15 is in the beginning. So we use forward interpolation formula to be easier. Okay. What is the step length here? You can make out very clearly what is the step length. Step length is 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. So step length h equals 0.1. Step length h equals 0.1. I hope it is clear here. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, the difference. Common difference is that is the step length. So h equals 0.1. Then we write the difference table. To write the difference table, we write this x value first. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 from this problem. And then we write the corresponding y values. That is 2.68, 3.04, 3.38 and 3.68. So when x is 0.1, given in the question, y is 2.68. When x is 0.2, y is 3.04. When x is 0.3, y is 3.38. Y or f of x value. Y and f of x is same. When x is 0.4, y is 3.68. It is as given in the question. Now, first difference will be at minus 3.04 minus 2.68. 3.04 minus 2.68, that will be 0.36. Just verify and see. Use your calculator and see whether I am correct. 3.38 minus 3.04. 3.38 minus 3.04 will be 0.34. Then 3.68 minus 3.38. 3.68 minus 3.38 is 0.30. Again, I repeat. 3.04 minus 2.68, 0.36. 3.38 minus 3.04, 0.34. 3.68 minus 3.38, 0.30. That is the first difference. Then comes the second difference. Here, 0.34 minus 0.36. When you subtract, always you can't subtract, like you have to subtract from second minus first, like this. And write it in the middle. When you subtract this, write in the middle. That procedure you follow. It will be easy. So 0.34 minus 0.36 for the second difference minus 0.0. Do you know why minus sign? 0.30 minus 0.34 minus 0.04. And the third difference is minus 0.04 minus of minus will be plus. Minus of minus will be plus. So minus 0.04 plus 0.02 minus into minus plus. So we get minus 0.02. I hope it is clear. So the first mark will be given for the correct forward difference table. Okay. Now from the table, you know x0 is 0.1. See x0 is 0.1. y0 is 2.68. Del y0 is 0.36. All the leading elements are right. Del squared y0 is minus 0.02. Del cubed y0 is minus 0.02. This is all the values, leading diagonal, leading elements we are writing down. So what is our aim? Our aim is to find y or f of x. Our aim is to find y or f of x when x equals 0.15. See? When x is 0.15, that means we have to find f of 0.15. That is y when x equals 0.15. Different ways of interpretation. So first we will find p. P is equal to, as we have done in the previous problem, x minus x naught by h. P is equal to x minus x naught by h. So x is 0.15 minus x naught is 0.1 divided by h. H is the difference here, common difference in x value given independent variables. It is 0.1. So 0.5 minus x naught 0.1 divided by h 0.1. You know how to simplify this, I need not tell you. It will be 0.05 divided by 0.1, so it will be 0.5. You know, using calculators or simple division it is. Now we go to the question. That is, we write the interpolating polynomial y equals or f of x equals y equals or f of x equals or x is f of 0.15 equals whatever. Y naught p into delta y naught. Here even delta y cubed is there. See, delta y cubed is also 0.02. So we have to write till delta y cubed term. Next term does not exist. So y naught plus p into delta y naught plus p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial delta squared y naught plus p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 by 3 factorial delta cube y naught. So substitute all the values. Y naught is 2.68. P value is 0.5 and delta y naught is 0.36. Okay. So 0.5 into 0.5 minus 1 divided by 2 factorial is 2. Delta squared y naught. Delta squared y naught means minus 0.02. Minus 0.02 substitute. Right here in the p values 0.5, 0.5 minus 1, 0.5 minus 2 divided by 3 factorial. 3 factorial is nothing but 3 into 2. That is 6. Del cubed y naught. Del cubed y naught means this value here. y naught del y naught del squared y naught del cubed y naught. So it's again minus 0.02, and this is a simple calculation in your calculator, or you can multiply also. Better to use calculator. Calculator is allowed in this module. Okay, because the name itself says it is numerical methods. So 2.86125. So one of the important, all are important questions only. Same type of question with change in number will appear in your exams. You can see the model paper also to get the idea what type of questions they will give. One more question you will see. A function y is equal to f of x is given by the following table. Okay, a function y is equal to f of x is given by the following table. X value, y value. Y value is also called as f of x. So x value is 1.0, 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, 1.8, 2.0 as given in the question. Y value is 0.00, 0.128, 0.544, 1.296, 2.432, 4.00. Okay. Now find an approximate value of f of 1.1. Question is, find an approximate value of f of 1.1. Find an approximate value of f of 1.1. Question is, okay. Now here, first the step length. What is the step length? You can see clearly 1 became 1.2, then 1.4, 1.6, 1.8, 2.0. So clearly the step length h is 0.2. Okay, the difference table, first we write the x values. 1.0, 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, 1.8, 2.0 as given in the question. As given in the question. Then we write the y values as given in the question. When x is 1, y is 0.00. When x is 1.2, y is 0.128. When x is 1.4, y value is 0.544. When x is 1.6, y value is 1.296. When x is 1.8, y value is 2.432. When x is 2.0, y value is 4. This is as given in the question. As given in the question, okay. Now the first difference. First difference how? This minus this. So 1.28 minus 1, 0.128, same thing. 0.54 minus 0.128, 0.416. 1.296 minus 0.544, 0.752. 2.432 minus 1.296, that is 1.136. 4.00 minus 2.432 is 1.568. Okay, that is the first difference. As before, problems are solved. Write and study. It's very simple. This is one of the scoring parts for you. Next, we go to the second difference. Same thing. Write all the values and write the answer in the middle. See, 0.416 minus 0.128, 0.28, write in the middle. 0.288. 0.752 minus 0.416, 0.336. 1.136 minus 0.752, 0.384. 1.568 minus 1.136, 0.432. Okay, then third difference. That's del cubed of y naught, that one. 0.336 minus 0.288, 0.048. 0.384 minus 0.336, 0.048. 0.432 minus 0.384, 0.048. Then the fourth difference, if you want, 0.048 minus 0.048 is 0. 0.048 minus 0.048 is 0. Okay, from the table now, x naught is 1.0, y naught is 0.00. Del y naught is 0.128, del squared y naught is 0.288, del cubed y naught is 0.048, and del power 4 of y naught is 0.00. So we have to write the forward interpolation formula till del cube of y naught, because the next all terms are zeros. Del 4 y naught is 0. We have to find f of x at question. What is the question? We have to find f of x at x equals 1.1. So x value is 1.1. Okay, we'll find p value. P is x minus x naught by h. X is 1.1 as given in the question, minus x naught is the initial value, 1.0. 1.1 minus 1.0 divided by h. H is the common difference. 1.0, 1.2, 1.4, 1.6. What difference you see? The same length, step length. So that is h is 0.2. So calculate this. 1.1 minus 1.0, that is 0.1 divided by 0.2, that is 1 by 2, which is equal to 0.5. It's equal to 0.5. Okay. Now we write the Newton's forward interpolation formula, f of x equal to or y equal to. F of x equal to or y equal to. But here in the question, we have to find the value of f of x at x equals 1.1. You can see the question here. Value of f of x at x equals 1.1. So we write f of x equal to f of 1.1 equal to, or you can write y equals y naught plus p delta y naught plus p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial delta squared y naught. Goes on, you can write Newton's forward interpolation formula, you have to by heart. Derivation is not there. P into p minus 1 into p minus 2 divided by 3 factorial del cube of y naught plus p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 into p minus 3 by 4 factorial del power 4 of y naught. But del power 4 of y naught is 0. After that, everything will be 0. So we take the terms only till del cube of y naught. We write the values. Y naught is 0.00. P is 0.5 into del y naught is 0.128. You can see here all values I have written. All the values have been written here. Okay. P is 0.5. So 0.5 into 0.5 minus 1 divided by 2 factorial is 2. 2 factorial is 2. Into del squared of y naught. Del squared of y naught is 0.288. Okay. Then P into 0.5 into P minus 1, 0.5 minus 1 into 0.5 minus 2 divided by 3 factorial, that is 6, del cube of y naught, that is 0.048, okay. This term will be 0, last term, because del power 4 of y naught is 0, no need of writing that. So substitute all the values, then simple calculations. I might be wrong, just check it whether I am correct or wrong. Don't simply write the answer what I have written. Okay, you will get the final answer as 0.031. You should be correct till 3 decimal place, or you write till 4 decimal place also. You know how to write to 4 decimal place. Write till 5 decimal place and approximate the 4th decimal place. Okay, the next question. Given that sine 45 degrees, so here one value is degrees. Sine 45 degrees 0.7071. Sine 50 degrees 0.7660. It will be given in the question, sine 55 degrees 0.819 to sine 60 degrees 0.8660. Find sine of 48 degrees. So x, this is x value. Given data is x in degrees. So we take given data is what? X in degrees. So x in degrees, what you get? 45, 50, 55, 60. So 45, 50, 55, 60. You know how I wrote it. Okay. Then the function is sine x, sine 45, sine 55, sine 50, like that. So f of x is sine x, or y equals f of x equals sine x. Value is 45 means it is 0.7071, 50 means it is 0.7660, 55 means it is 0.8192, 60 means it is 0.8660. And what about the step length? Next you have to see the step length. Step length h equals the common difference here, 45 to 50. 50 to 55, 55 to 60, so it is 5. Difference table we write down. First we write the x value, 45, here you can see 45, 50, 55 and 60. Then you write the corresponding y values, f of x values, sine x 0.7, when x is 45, y is 0.7071, x is 50, 0.7660 as given in the question. X is 55, that is sine 55, f of x 0.8192, x is 60, sine 60, 0.8660. First difference, second difference, third difference, fourth difference, like that. So first difference is this minus this, second minus first, always second minus first. 0.7660 minus 0.7071, 0.0589. 0.8192 minus 0.7660, 0.0532. 0.8660 minus 0.8192, 0.0468. Okay, coming to second difference, always write in the middle, you can see in the middle. 0.0532 minus 0.0589, you will get minus 0.0057. You know why minus? Because second term is bigger. 0.0468 minus 0.0532 minus 0.0064. Verify whether I am correct. Again here, third difference. Minus 0.0064 minus into minus plus 0.0057. Because minus of this minus into minus plus minus 0.0007. Okay. Next term is not there because single here. And from the table now, x naught is 5, y naught is 0.7071, del y naught is 0.058, and all the leading elements. You have seen in previous problem, same. Del squared y naught is minus 0.0057, del cube y naught is minus 0.0007. Now the question is to find f of x, that is f of 1.5. To find f of x equals sine x at x equals, what is it? At x equals, question, sine 48. So to find f of x is equal to sine x at x equals 48. That is, in other words, to find y is equal to f of x equals sin x at x equals 48. P is equal to x minus x naught by h. Very important formula. X is 48. X naught is 45. 48 minus 45 by the step length h. Step length h here you can see 45, 50, 55, 60. It is 5. If I calculate 3 by 5, that is 0.6. P value is 0.6. Now write the Newton's forward interpolation formula. Y equals f of x equals like y naught plus p delta y naught plus p into p minus 1 by 2 factorial delta squared y naught plus p into p minus 1 by p minus 2 by 3 factorial delta cube y naught. We have got only till delta cube y naught. If you want, you can write the next term. That will be p into p minus 1 into p minus 2 into p minus 3 by 4 factorial delta power 4 y naught. But delta power 4 y naught does not exist here. Clear? Then write all the values. Okay, y naught value, p into delta y naught value. Write all the values, calculate it. Then finally we get, if you calculate this, you will get answer 0.7430848. Okay, I approximate it to 5 decimal place, 0.7431. I approximate to 4 decimal place. This is number greater than 5, so 0.7431. So sine 48 equals 0 point, because I put x equals 48, so f of 48. So f of 48 will be nothing but, because f of x is sine x I have taken, you see. F of 48 will be sine 48. This is calculated for 48, you know that. Sine x at x equals 48. See, calculated for this. So it's not sine x at x equals 48. P value is calculated at x equals 48. So sine of 48 is 0.7431. So the time is up. I would like to summarize. Today we solved problems in, we studied first Newton's forward interpolation formula, where h is the step length, p x minus x naught by h, and then we form the forward difference table, and then we use the Newton's forward interpolation formula. We solved about two or three problems of very important type from the model question paper. We'll solve some more problems in the next session and then go to Newton's backward interpolation formula. So for forward interpolation formula, Newton's forward interpolation formula, we have to use forward difference. For Newton's backward interpolation formula, we have to use backward difference. Okay, here it is. We are studying Newton's forward difference formula. So practice the notes, practice the problems. Any doubts you can clarify later, or you can call me or message me or whatever. Be clarified. Okay, now I wind up the session. Thank you. All the best. Thank you. All the best. Wind up the session here. Yeah.